I'm going to show you a new alternative method with audio spectrum effects where we can visualize music. We will continue with triangle-like shapes with audio spectrum effect and the background that supports this visualization. First, we add our music to the scene. I got this music from YouTube's sound library. Then let's create a new composition. As we always do, I created a 30-second composition with a black background, 1920 to 1080 pixels. Then I drag the sound file I just added into the sequence. I press the letter L from the keyboard, so we turn on the sound wave feature. When I click on the arrow of this, we will see the sound waves. It's music with these tones when we listen to the preview. Now, we will create a new solid layer because we will analyze this audio spectrum effect that we will create over this solid. Therefore, I right click on the sequence, choose new and choose solid. By clicking the make comp size button, we can make it exactly the size of the sequence we just created. I name it audio spectrum and click the OK button. Now you can make this audio spectrum effect on various shapes. I'm going to show you now how it can be done with a triangle. However, we cannot draw a triangle directly. We will do this indirectly. I get a rectangle tool. I'm starting to draw the rectangle. If you press the shift key on the keyboard, you will draw a full square. When we delete one of the points, we will get a triangle. I click on the pen tool and select the delete vertex tool. Now I click on the dot in the last lower corner of this rectangle we have drawn. It doesn't matter which one though. When I click on it, it deletes the dot there. So this creates a triangle for us. Because we want to make this exactly a downward facing triangle, I choose the selection tool. The shortcut is the letter V and I double click on the dots. When I click twice, it will highlight all the points. And when I rotate the keyboard by pressing the shift key, I will have a triangle pointing straight down. I press the enter key on the keyboard. I choose the point on the left first. Then I select the point on the right by pressing the shift key. Thus, both points will be selected. When I move it upwards with the arrow keys, we will have a complete triangle form. We got a triangle. Let's position it. Using the align panel, we can ensure that this is centered. If you do not have the align panel, you can access it with the align option under the window. If you don't have this, make sure the effects option under the window is checked. I'm typing audio spectrum here. When I write this, there is already one effect under the generate folder. I'm putting this effect on the solid layer we just created. We won't see anything when we play it right now, because we haven't integrated this audio spectrum effect into any music. In order to make this association, we need to change the audio layer option in the effect controls panel to the music file we added. When I select it and play it, you will see the sound waves here. This is the wave that you see in one line. We want to impose this on the triangle. Therefore, we select the path option here from none to mask 1. The mask name automatically given the triangle we just created in mask 1. When I select it and play it, we are associated with the triangle. As you can see, by choosing this, we associate the triangle form with music. Now we can edit these values. I change the start frequency property to 1. By the way, if you don't want to see the triangle here, you can click the toggle mask icon to turn off the appearance of the triangle. And we will only see the spectrum effect. We will also need to lower the end option a bit. Let's get this down to 500 so we can see the sound waves well. The lower you lower it, the closer the sound waves will become. It doesn't need that much, so 500 is ideal. Let's change the value of 64 to 100. Thus, we will see the lines between them a little more. We will have a more cramped appearance. If you want to change the thickness of these lines, you can change the thickness value. For example, when I do 1, we will get a much thinner look. When I do 5, we will get a thicker look. Let's leave it as 2 for now and set the softness value to 0 as well. We will be able to see the lines much more clearly. Let's make the colors white. Later we will have the opportunity to change these colors. And another option that is important here is the side options value. If you just choose A, it will give the spectrum effect from one side, that is, to the inner side. If you just choose B, it will give it to the outside. If you choose both A and B, it will have given both sides of this spectrum effect. You can customize this for yourself. Let's set it to be side B right now. Now I shrink this audio spectrum effect and create a copy with Ctrl D. Now we will change this display options option. You are now seeing the digital part. Let's change that to analog lines. When I change this, you will see that the other effect disappears. However, if you click on the composite on original option, we will see both the background image, the audio spectrum effect in the background, and the line effect we just created. Let's also activate the previous composite on original option. Thus, we will eliminate the overlapping problem. We are going to make them all appear. This is the line we created. That is, we can increase or decrease the thickness value of the line from here. Let's change it to 1 right now. And now I'm closing it again. And as spectrum 3, I make a new copy with Ctrl D and this time convert it from analog lines to analog dots. Let's change the maximum height to 800 here and change the thickness value to 3 to see the points here better. 800 is too much, we can change it to 600. Then, let's set it to be site A. You can customize them according to you. You may not even want to use some of them. I'm showing these as an example. Now, I want to apply a similar effect to the left side. So first, we will add a mirror effect. I'm dragging the mirror effect over the audio spectrum layer. Then I change the value here to 180. When I change it to 180, it won't show up because I need to center this center point. I click on the center point and set it to be right in the middle. Since we have a 90, 20, 1080 pixels project, we can also solve the center point directly by entering a number. Here I am typing 960 and typing 540. Thus, we have adjusted it so that it coincides with the middle. Now, you can preview what we are doing by pressing the 0 key on the keyboard. You can check the adjustments over and over again by playing with the values here momentarily. Now that we have done the mirror part, we can turn this part off. Alternatively, let's add a stroke effect. I'm dragging the stroke effect under Generate over the mirror. Thus, we will see a border of this mask that we have created. When I change the brush size to 1, we can get a nice effect. Or let's change that to 2. Like I said, you have to edit it your way. Let's also turn off the stroke effect. Now, we can start working on the background. For this, I need to create a new background. I right-click New Solid Layer with White Background and click OK button. Now, we will make this background with Starburst effect. Therefore, I write Starburst in the Effects section and drag the Starburst effect under the Simulation category onto the background. When I play this scene, you will see the dots coming towards you. To reverse this, I change the speed option to -1. So the dots will have gone forward. I change the grid spacing and size values to 20. This way, we will see an effect. And let's add a new effect. Let's add the radial fast blur effect. I'm putting this effect on the background layer, and when I play it like that, let's see what the result is. We will reach the end of this animation when we add the glow effect. If the stars here seem too much, you can increase the scatter value a little more, like 300. You will get a much less starry look. We currently do not see the audio spectrum effect at the top of the triangle. In order to see this, I click on the audio spectrum layer, select the audio spectrum layer, and press the letter M from the keyboard. When I press the letter M, we will see mask 1. When I change the add option next to it to none, you will see that the audio spectrum effect at the top is also visible. Now, let's add the glow effect. I type glow in the search box. I drag the glow option under stylize over the audio spectrum. First, let's change the threshold value to 20%. We will try to create a wider glow effect by duplicating these layers as well. I copy this with Ctrl D and change the radius value to 100. I also change the intensity value to 0.5. I copy the glow effect again and change the radius to 300. Then, I'm turning off the properties of the glow effect. Now, let's add adjustment layer to create a nice color. I right-click, select New, Adjustment Layer. I change its name to Color by pressing the Enter key on the keyboard. And I type Curves in the search box in the effects panel. We can drag this effect onto the adjustment layer we created. You can create your own color by fiddling with the options here. For example, I click on the red and scroll the red line like this. If I click on the green and edit on the green, that way I can change the colors. I can also create other colors with blue. Since the colors are already made of RGB, you can create the color you want in this way. To make the colors look more dynamic, I come to the Project Settings option under File. I'm changing the color option from 8 bits to 16 bits. You can make the colors more vivid by clicking the OK button. You can then move the timeline to the beginning and press 0 to get it rendered. Initially, while this preview render, our audio file may have slowed down. It's getting preview rendering, as it's called. You will see and hear this more normally when you render. That's it for this video. In this video, we made an alternative to the audio spectrum effect. If this video helped you out, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.